I build in the sky. You were my queen, a queen. You the eyes, the lips, and the hair of the girl in my castle.
That was lovely, Kit.
Come on, Bill. Let's turn in. We got to get that top up the first thing in the morning.
All right, Joe. Let's go. Okay.
That's a good idea. Come on, let's go.
They can do their stuff as well as that young fella can sing. They sure must have a fine show.
He's the young fella that wants to buy that horse of yours. Why don't you go over and talk to him?
Oh, he's not interested in horses right now.
Well, I'm not interested in sticking around here all night. I'll get him.
Pardon me, mister, but Mr. Leyton over here would like to talk to you about a horse. I don't like to break in on your consolation, but we're kind of anxious to get on back home. Do you mind if you talk to him?
Sure, I'll be right over.
Thanks.
Excuse me, Alicia.
Good night, miss.
Mr. Denton?
That's right.
My name is Leyton.
Glad to know you, Leyton.
I heard you were in the market for a horse.
Yes, I am.
Well, I've got one I'd like to show you.
Did you bring him with you?
No, I didn't. But I thought maybe you could come out to the Williams Ranch and have a look at him.
Fine. I'll be over in the morning.
All right.
Who's the boss of this outfit?
Mr. Rainey, but he's in town right now. Is there anything I can do for you?
Yeah. You can tell him that Chris McDonald sent word over to keep right on going. He don't like circuses or circus people. And what he says goes in big bands.
Well, you can tell McDonald that Mr. Rainey is the boss of this outfit. And what he says goes around here.
You heard what he said, Connors. Now listen to this. Big Bend likes circuses and circus people. And I reckon we're going to see this one.
Yeah? Well, we'll see about that.
Who is this fella McDonald?
He just about runs this country. We never could figure out what he's got against show people.
Yeah, he's got his hands into everything. The town is getting pretty tired of it.
Reckon you're the queen of the show, huh? Wait a minute. Don't go away. Hey, you're a pretty swell dish to be hanging around a circus.
Let go of me.
Wait a minute.
Take your hands off.
I won't bite.
Kit! Kit!
All right, you circus clown, start something.
How many times have I told you not to fight? Especially over a woman. Any woman. There's not one of them that's worth it.
Thank you.
Connor. If you come to in time, bring McDonald to the circus.
Looks like you folks can take care of yourselves. However, if you do tie in with McDonald and his outfit, you can depend on us.
Thanks, boys.
Good night.
Good night.
I'm sorry for what Dad said, Alicia. And I know how you must feel about it. He didn't mean it.
I've heard him talk before. He doesn't like me. He doesn't like any woman. But he must have loved your mother.
Yes, I suppose so. I never knew my mother. Dad has forbidden me to even speak of her.
I'm sorry, Keith.
It's getting late, honey. You better get some sleep.
Good night.
Good night. You haven't been yourself lately, Dad. What's the trouble?
You understood me out there, didn't you, Kit? When I spoke about old women. I don't want you to fight over them. What did Alicia say after I left?
Nothing at all, Dad.
You like her a lot, don't you, Kit?
Ah, let's forget it. What do you think about this fellow McDonald? Saying that we can't show here tomorrow.
That's not our affair. It's up to Rainey. And as far as I'm concerned, the sooner we're out of this country, the better. Kit, I'd hoped that it would never be necessary to tell you this, but it's time that you knew that I'm a hunted man. I'm wanted in this country. Now you know why I've kept in seclusion, why I've never appeared in public, only through the mask of a clown. You were born here. I carried you away a babe in arms. You're all I've got, Kit. You wouldn't understand. Oh, I hate this country and everything about it.
Don't worry about it anymore, Dad. We'll be out of here in a couple of days. What do you say to a game of checkers?
All right, son. So you think you're going to beat me, eh?
Well, at least I'm going to keep on trying.
Got everything ready for the big top, Mr. Rainey.
Good, Silver. Get the boys together and get her up.
All
Come on, boys. Let's get
it up. Mr. McDonald, there's Rainey. He's the fellow that runs the show.
Are you running this outfit?
I'm the owner, yes.
Well, I sent you word, Rainey, that you couldn't show here.
Well, just how are you going to stop me? I've got permission to put my tents up on this property, and they're going up right now.
Well, I'm warning you, Rainey. You may start your show, but you'll never finish it.
Well, you may think you're running this town, but you're not running me in my circus. Now, you better get going before you get in trouble.
The trouble will be all yours, Rainey.
Yeah. I'm going over and have a look at that horse, Dad.
All right, son.
I won't be gone long.
Connors. See that man over there by the wagon?
Yeah, what about him?
Well, take a good look at him so you won't forget him. And find out somehow before the performance tonight just what he does with the show.
Glad to see you.
How are you, Mr. Leyton?
Just fine, thanks.
Where's that horse you were telling me about?
Well, come on, I'll show him to you. Well, here he is. What do you think of him?
Sure is a fine-looking animal.
I had that trick saddle put on him in case you might want to try him out.
Well, that's not a bad idea. Well, you boys take this hat, will you?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Well, Mr. Denton, you do any of that trick riding with the show?
Once in a while.
He sure worked fine for you.
He sure did.
Oh, Mrs. Williams, this is Miss Russo.
How do you do?
And Mr. Denton.
How do you do, Mrs. Williams?
I'm awfully glad to know you.
They're the stars of the show that's in town. Mr. Denton is interested in buying a horse, and he's been looking at Boy.
Well, you've been looking at a mighty fine animal. And if I'm any judge, I think you're the kind of a young man that'll take good care of
him. I sure would, Mrs. Williams. How much do you want for him? $5,000. I consider that a pretty fair bargain, Mr. Leyton.
I'll have him over there for you this afternoon.
Would you folks care to see the show this evening?
Well, we had intended going.
Well, I'd like to have you as my guest.
Oh, thanks so much. We'll be there.
You just show them this pass and they'll take care of you.
Oh, thanks.
Here comes Chris McDonald.
Well, we'll see you all this evening.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Thank you so much.
Well, Lucy, I'll be there. So long.
Good morning, Chris.
Good morning, Martha. Circus people, huh?
Yes, and lovely young people, too. The young man is the star of the circus. He bought a horse from Jim.
Oh, I see. Martha, I tried to stop them from showing here. I wanted to spare you the memory of circuses and circus people.
I've lived in those memories.
Still waiting, huh? It's been 18 years, Martha, and I still love you.
He gave me some passes for the show.
You're not going, are you?
It's a good many years since I've been to a circus, Chris, and I'm not going to miss this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the largest, the heaviest, the biggest, the most impressive today, but my right, 798 pounds.
Barney-o. Look, over here, on my left, you'll see a three-legged boy.
Slick for you, wasn't I? been looking all over for you.
You didn't suppose you were going to find me up there with that wriggling female, did you?
Well, I'll tell you how it happened. I got pushed up in there and I couldn't get out.
Well, you're getting out right now.
You say this man Denton acts as a clown in the show? Find out what he looks like in his makeup. We don't want any mistakes.
Looks like we're going to have a pretty good crowd tonight.
Yeah. We're going to have a show in spite of McDonald.
I got him spotted. I'll handle this myself.
Good. The rest of you fellas have your instructions. You know what to do if they're in a slip-up.
Okay, boy.
Mm-hmm.
will you?
Okay, kid.
Hey, move the cart up here.
Sorry, son. It was my fault.
That's all right. I'm going up and finish it.
the matter, Dad?
Oh, I don't know. A little nervous, I guess.
You think you'll be all right for our big act?
Sure, I'm all right now. No worries, son.
Thank you.
feet of Gary!
Thank you. Hang on, Dad.
Dressing room.
All right.
Take good care of him, Doc. I'm going to find out who did this.
You shot my dad, Connors. I want to know why.
McDonald. He forced me to do it. He wanted to wipe him out.
What was his reason?
I don't know. Let go. Let go. You're breaking my arm.
This fella did the shooting, Sheriff.
All right, Denton. We'll take care of him.
Get him up here, boys.
He sure stuck both of the show. That's what I call stopping the show.
You don't mind waiting a minute, Martha?
Certainly not.
McDonald!
McDonald, Connors just confessed. Why did you want to kill my dad?
Your dad. Denton, your dad.
Here, put the cuff on him, boys.
Son, I'm done for. But before I go, I want to right a wrong done many years ago. I loved your mother. I hated your father because she loved him. She's always loved him. For that love, that hate, I was fool enough to kill. I framed your father. He was accused of crime. Your mother, she's...
How is he, Doc?
Why, it's only a flesh wound. And with careful nursing, he'll be all right.
Gee, that's great news.
Now, I'll be back first thing in the morning.
Fine, Doctor.
Good night.
Good night.
If there's anything I can do for you, call me, too.
Thanks, honey. Dad, there's something I've just got to tell you. I found my mother. She's not the woman you thought she was. She's waited for you all these years.
It was McDonald who caused all this trouble. He was shot. But before he died, Dad, he confessed how he tricked you into believing that you were a murderer. It was he who did the killing.
Martha.
The girl that I loved long ago.
18 wasted years. Years of tears and sorrow. For the rest of our lives. Make me laugh, Charlie.
Castle of air, and you say.